So what are we doing?
Suffering.
Suffering. Got it.
Suffering.
Got it. I know exactly what we're doing then.
So you have three options right now.
Do
I? Three fantastic options. Yay.
Why choose option A?
What?
I said I choose option A.
Option Artorias?
yes.
Wait, that's two of the options. I still don't know what you want to do.
Well,
so one of the options is that you could keep going down Lava Land and fight whatever's down there. The other option is that you can go into New Londa Ruins and fall in that hole that killed you before, because now it won't kill you if you wear that one ring that makes it not kill you. The Covenant of the Artorias. Or you can go into the DLC.
Oh, right. Wait, did I unlock the DLC?
Which is the Artorias of the Abyss DLC.
I thought I didn't unlock it.
So you have to go back to Hydra if you want to do that.
Yeah, but I thought I didn't unlock it because even though I killed the guy, I thought you were supposed to get an item or something.
Yeah, I explained that you're supposed to do something at the Hydra place first, then come back and kill that crystal. Yes, it's really fucking obtuse.
In a Dark Souls game? You don't say.
Well, like, it's weirdly obtuse as far as DLC goes.
Shit, where was that hole? Fuck, where was that hole? Was that hole downstairs, or was it upstairs?
Oh, you mean the boss hole?
Yeah, it was downstairs, right?
It was at the very end.
Of the upstairs or the downstairs?
It was like when you were running past all the Death Stalkers and stuff.
Okay, so downstairs.
Dark Stalk shit. I think they are Death Stalkers.
Dankstalkers. The Valley of the Danks.
The Valley of the Danks.
Oh God.
So a way to get in there would be potentially to try, running past these drakes. Yeah.
Running. Excuse me.
Are you gonna fight all the drakes?
I am going to kill the drakes.
I don't think they. I don't think they stop spawning.
Oh, they don't? They're constantly spawning?
I don't have reason to think they don't despawn.
They're kind of scary. They're drakes.
Usually the permanent despawn enemies are, like, unique. And not, like, a horde of the same thing repeating through an area.
Well, yeah, but
there's, like, five of them.
But they're only in this area.
Yeah, but
I mean,
like,
those guys who blow fucking poison
in your face. I can't think of any
face.
Example of there being, like, five guys grouped together that despawn forever when you kill them, really.
The guys who blow poison at your face.
The blow dart people?
Yeah, the blow dart people.
Yeah, those are weird.
They're like, there's
I
one.
I can't think
the
of
back,
another.
The back
I can't
area.
Think of a single example in the entire series off the top of my head that fits quite the weird blow dart example where there's like, the entire area is filled with this one enemy type that never respawns, but like they're everywhere. Like it's unusual. It's not a rule at least. It's at least not a rule to like, try to filter the game through and assume that'll happen more often.
Can I backstab a drake?
You generally can only backstab humanoids, and in a few weird cases, pig-shaped monsters. Not really sure why.
A backstab!
They just like the image of you shoving your hand up a pig's ass, I guess.
I went right into that. But he also curved in a weird arc. So.
Yep. The danger direction is the front direction. Yeah, good luck aggroing them one at a time, by the way.
It's time to duel. That just stays. Okay, you're just gonna spam that. That just stays in the air for a while, doesn't it?
Yeah, it kind of just occupies space. He is like continually spraying more of it too.
I can stun him.
Yeah. Sometimes.
Sometimes. But I haven't lost a lot of life yet. Not enough that one flask can't take care of it. Now I will. I will lose a lot of life, I bet.
Oh,
I'm just going to take this item.
There's not even two of them. There's way more.
Well, there's just three, and also I pulled one by itself. So, you know, go me. But I also can't fight on this bridge. No! I just can't fight on the bridge. You can come.
Nope. He's out of here. That backing up animation is incredible, by the way.
That is a terrible backup animation. You can come. No. Okay, now you're just an asshole.
He just wants to sing Billie Jean. Oh, you're dead. Okay, Bye.
Why didn't I want to fight on the bridge, Keith? Oh, I don't know, because I was afraid the dragon was going to do what dragons do, which is spam a fucking attack on the ground that you can't hit them doing.
Well, now we get to know whether they despawn or not after we do this long walk.
Long walk.
Enjoy.
Long walk in nowhere.
Well,
at least I'm not human anymore.
To nowhere.
So that's nice. Getting rid of humanity is kind of a helpful tool.
Now you don't have to deal with any of those pesky summons being available for the next boss fight.
Well, I also don't have to deal with pesky fucking invaders.
When's the last time you were invaded?
Once, and that was all it took.
Is that still the only invasion?
Yes.
Really?
Because I spent 90% of the game as dead, as a hollow.
I'm just thinking back, like, I was trying to think of any other invasion. I was like, surely they've happened, right?
No. I think someone attempted to invade one time, remember?
Someone tried to invade you when you're running into ONS and you despawned them by going into the boss fight.
Yeah. So, twice I've been invaded. One was attempted.
Huh. Weird.
I'm also playing it at the least height of its popularity, so it's handy.
Yeah, you're playing it you're playing it 6 years after release, and you're playing it, like, we're generally playing it in the middle of the day on a weekday.
Yeah. So my hope is that maybe everyone who would be playing this, aka children,
like, this entire series has been recorded on Tuesdays and Thursdays at approximately, like, 2 p.m.
Don't tell them when the fuck it's happening. I don't want people, like, trying to log on and catch me unawares. The last thing I need is, like, some asshole just like, haha.
Hey, by the time any of this airs on my channel, the thing's over already.
Your freaking people are watching on my channel right now.
They are the chosen few.
Yeah, and they will
and
probably,
now they have a mission.
And they will probably be dedicated to spite me.
They're gonna have to move. They're gonna have to act fast if they want to do that, because we're running out of game.
Good.
They can come after you in the DLC, I guess. Like, there's only so much game left.
Let me just try to.
Yep, they respawn.
God damn it.
Get fact.
So then I'll just have to run past the three at the edge over there.
Yep. There is an item, but you might die getting it.
Ah, whatever. I can't really avoid that.
Souls.
It's only 1,000. Some pathetic amount. All right.
So you know the mob of drakes?
Yeah.
To the right of them, there's a ladder that leads to an item, but also a dead end. And I don't remember if the item is useful. But you'll likely have the bottom of the staircase being mobbed by drakes if you do it. So I don't know how easy it'll be to actually leave if you tried.
So wait, where you're talking about...
That tower on their right?
That tower?
There's a ladder going up it.
What?
I believe. I think it's the smaller tower.
Oh, that yeah. Small tower. Okay, I was like, wait, what?
I think there's a ladder going up there, and there's an item at the top that I think is unique, but I don't remember if it's worth getting or not. And if you do get it, the bottom of the ladder is probably going to be swarmed by drakes at that point.
Oh my god.
I think that was a grab?
Did you literally not?
Plus 5 health flask.
Yep, it is handy. That's alright.
It's definitely getting more powerful.
Oh, there is a ladder right there. I see it. I see its little butt ladder.
Good luck, have fun. Either run to the ladder or run past them, but you're gonna get lightninged.
That's okay! Because they're gonna be stupid about it!
No jumping attacks, please.
Oh my god, they are howling. They are calling for blood. I nailed it. These drakes are stupid. I'm just gonna jump off the ledge and fucking attack them.
Yeah, no joke. I actually watched the game audio. I actually watched the game audio peak. Just from how much was happening.
Was it really?
Yeah, it went red. I guess that was all that was there. So it's one of those things that gives you... It probably gives you bonus attack when you're low on health.
Yeah, bonus attack when HP is low.
Never using that.
Yeah.
Probably. Good luck.
Is there like a way I can jump off from the ladder and then hit them?
If you double tap circle, you might let go and then you could hit R1 to attack. I don't know if that works in every game or not, the double tap circle. Let go. I'll just like mash that circle button a bit.
Nope.
Oh no.
Okay, well, I still land on their head.
Oh, yeah, he did actually like triple stun them. Yeah. That's amazing. Remember the Deathstalkers.
Yeah, but the Deathstalkers aren't as scary as the Drakes. Darksters.
Not the Deathstalkers.
Oh, right. I should probably wrong button.
I should probably pull out my shield. Put it away.
Pull out a fucking head.
Did
instead.
Literally the opposite of putting it away.
Oh, one of them died.
Oh, not him though.
No, one of the Drakes died.
Are you gonna fight him?
No, I'm just gonna make sure he doesn't fucking chase me.
You. They get up fast. You gotta go. Oh, he's dead.
Not anymore. They used to get up
wow,
fast.
Wow, your backstab kills them now? You might be able to do pretty well against this boss.
So maybe like,
I rank this boss and ONS as being the hardest bosses in this game. But it's also, this one's kind of a DPS race, so you might have a very gargantuan advantage
against
boss.
It.
It might... I genuinely don't know how it's going to go. But I know it's the most punishing boss to lose against, because if you lose against it, you have to run all the way here again.
Yeah, that does sound
There is no bonfire anywhere in this entire zone. And there's a few quote-unquote shortcuts that really are terrible. Like, none of them are very helpful at making the trip shorter. And every path involves enemies to either run past or fight. So it's not a great situation to be in.
Well, I'm killing these guys real easily, so that's been handy.
There's also a summon for this boss fight that basically makes it harder.
What?
Yeah. I think you can summon a spellcaster for this boss fight, but like, I think that the boss itself is resistant.
Oh right, spooky ghost.
Yep.
Forgot about the spooky ghost.
I think the boss might be resistant to magic, and so she's kind of useless. And summoning her gives it more health, so it's like it makes the fight even harder to DPS race through. I think that's what happens here, but I don't think you have access to that summon anyway.
Well, no, because I'm not human.
Well, also because I think you need to have summoned her before, because a lot of the summons in Souls games have like a story arc to them, where you have to summon them from boss fight to keep them in the story. Solaire is not like that. He just shows up at all the places as long as he's alive. But other NPCs, often you have to summon them at various spots to have them be available later, otherwise they just disappear or go hollow or die or something.
Huh.
And so she was a summon that you could have used for Moonlight Butterfly.
Ah, okay.
And I think if you summon her there, then she's available here. Otherwise, I think when you defeat this boss, she just shows up as a corpse somewhere. And you can get her loot.
Oh, well, like, that's even better.
Like, she just died off camera somewhere.
Ooh.
I think she dies off camera regardless, but you could have summoned her here if you had unlocked her, essentially. That's a big explosion.
That's not okay, by the way.
That's a big old boomy.
I really am not a big fan of a head just bursting out of nowhere.
When are you going to fight the weird nightmare?
Right now.
God, it's just hard to even articulate what it's made of. Hey, it's ghosty ghosts. Watch out. Don't lock onto them. You can't hurt them. That's an explosion. That did minimal damage.
How about the explosion?
Minimal explosion damage. Oop. Ow. He's phalanxing. He's phalanxing.
Okay, those are some long arms, girls. Cut your nails.
5,000 souls.
Wow, 5,000 souls for that guy?
Yeah.
Oh, this is the way, right?
That's the door.
Great.
Don't fall in the hole unless you're wearing the ring. And also be very careful you don't swap the ring out for the item that will break permanently if you take it off.
Are the ghosts going to come through here? Shit.
Oh, shit. Should have swapped that ring out earlier.
Yep. That's a good call.
So you're going to have to swap Havel for Artorias. And then you have to jump in the hole, and then if you really want to, you have to swap back. Otherwise, you'd have to wear lighter gear. And you have a lot of rings in your inventory, so have fun.
Where is it?
Covenant of Artorias.
And just jump down?
Just fall straight down the hole, basically. You don't have to go all the way down the staircase, necessarily, but you do have to not hit anything on the way down.
Yeah, I don't trust myself.
You probably shouldn't.
Oh, I run so slow, and I can't... I fat roll!
So I have no idea how this is going to go. You might beat this in one attempt.
Wait, is this going
to
go forever?
Or we might be here for 3 hours. It does not go forever.
Okay, good.
I think the only forever location in all of Dark Souls is the Gwendolyn boss fight.
Do you take damage?
Boom.
Good.
Better swap fast. Boom. Okay. Look for the boss fight and hit it a lot. And also watch out for bad things that happen to you in the fight.
Where am I?
Oh, you died. I guess you can't take the ring off. Yeah.
What?
I told you I didn't know the first time you asked, and we never researched it.
You can't take the ring off?
You can't.
You were taken by the abyss.
Okay, so time to get new gear that you cannot fat roll in, probably. I'll watch. What are you looking at?
There's like...
Are we looking at the mixer?
No. I was looking at my soul to wonder if it's actually viable to make a game this stupid. So it's... Okay, so I can't wear Havel's ring, so I have to wear non-Havel gear. Yeah. How much does non-Havel gear or non-Havel ring life weigh? Where is the fucking thing? Equipment 80, load. 87. So I'm at 50 of 87.6.
You need to go down to a lot lower.
Okay.
Like 43. 43.8. So you gotta remove 6.8, I think.
I'm not even at 100 equipment load yet.
Nope. That's not easy to get to.
Yeah. I'm noticing. How much is it?
We're in some heavy ass shit.
35 to level up. I wish you.
You're trying to see if you could level it up to make it better?
Yeah, I was trying to see if I could level up to have better equipment load.
You can probably get stuff that's marginally almost as good, and it's not that big of a deal, honestly.
No, it's
like,
not.
Like, the damage scaling is not that exactly exponential.
Don't want to change.
We know you have to, so just do it.
Let's see. God, Havel's helmet is so good.
Paladin helm?
Paladin helm seems reasonable.
Or you could put on that sweet, like...
I mean, it lowers it only by 10 for the most part. Everything's just by 10. Which is not bad.
How good was the Firekeeper set? Not the actual Firekeeper set, but the cool-looking one that the person in Analanda was wearing. Brass.
The brass helm? Not that great.
But it looks neat.
Yeah, well, it's...
my entire thought process.
Plays like poop.
Wait, go back there. Compare brass to crystal right above it. We can just look at them also.
You can... Wait, what?
The helm's, like, way lighter.
The helm is like, yeah, one lighter, but it has like no poison resistance or curse resistance.
Well, you're not gonna get hit by poison and curse. You're gonna be hit by magic.
I know.
But
this one actually has more magic defense too.
Yeah, but also weighs like an extra pound.
Yeah, well that's fine.
Not really, when the entire goal is to reduce your weight.
Well, yeah, but my fucking Havel helm weighs like 7. So dropping it to 5 is a pretty substantial amount. I just need to find something equivalent. Oh, there you go. Equivalent magic defense.
And like no physical defense.
That's fine. Maybe he only does magic fights,
right? He
does
not only do magic.
Well, there we go. That's fine. Physical and good magic. I mean, it's only 3 pounds. It's got
the helm of the channelers. You look ridiculous. It'll be amazing.
Perfect.
You're like the bad guy from Shadows of the Damned.
Oh,
where his
yeah.
head was a weird tower of eyes. Like, he just kept having more eyes. Like, that's a weird choice, how you keep having more eyes.
It's a weird choice that you keep adding more to yourself.
Yo, dude, what's with the eyes? You can just put on the entire Chandler set.
The brig is also nice.
The brigand. You just pick that up on the bridge.
It's 3.1, plus it's got 20... Well, it's only got 23 physical defense, which isn't great, actually. But magic is 20, which is nice.
Isn't the crimson robe better? Wow, the brigand armor has lower weight than the caster set, the crimson robe.
Yeah, crimson robe actually might be better.
That's weird.
Let's do crimson robe. How are these? 25... Wow, I don't have a lot of... I think the gloves are fine, actually.
Well, what gloves are you wearing?
I am wearing these.
Yeah?
They're kind of okay for the most part. Everything else weighs about the same or more.
Your goal is to cut out about 7.
Which I think I've already done. But let's check pants.
Pants.
Let's check pants. Oh, these are 0.5 less, but are actually better pants.
Yeah, the Chandler's set actually is better than the Silver Knight set for both defense on physical and magical. That might be true for the gloves, too. Did you check them?
Nice. It's a good roll.
You look ridiculous.
You look ridiculous.
Let's just make that your new appearance for the rest of the game.
Gwyn, no.
Yeah.
I mean, Havel's helm is it's still better than this weird ass fucking mask.
Nope. This is your new appearance for the rest of the game. This is what you look like.
Ugh.
You're beautiful.
God, I gotta fucking. I gotta warp my ass all the way
back.
We
really should have checked to see if you were allowed to take the ring off.
We really should have. Why can't you? I don't. What a stupid boss.
Because it fights you, it protects you from the abyss.
Well, if you said it was a DPS fight, I might as well just fucking have took the brunt of it and just beat him up.
Yeah.
Just taking the slow fat roll and didn't give a shit.
We should have just planned for keeping the ring on.
Oh well, life is never that fun. So where are my souls at? I guess on the bridge or on the staircase?
They might be, yeah, I don't know how fast you took the ring off, like how that'll affect it.
I took it pretty fast.
So I don't know for sure the exact amount of time they rewind you for, like, for deciding where your souls go. It's like they could be on the ground in the boss fight.
What is this ring buff?
What?
My stamina comes back really quickly? Is that what it's telling me? Or is it a run speed increase? What the fuck is this foot?
I think it's just the Abyss Walker.
What does that mean? It just means that I can go into that stupid abyss?
Yeah.
You don't need a fucking symbol for that.
Yeah, they show you a symbol for every ring you put on. I think even helms that give you buffs have like an icon for them.
Can you cut that bridge?
I don't think so.
Okay. I was wondering, like, maybe if someone invaded me, I could just cut the bridge.
And then it's just, that shortcut's there, just gone forever.
Yeah, it's worth it.
Permanent damage to the inventory. I mean, the environment. I won't say that you can't cut bridges in Souls games, but I don't think you can cut that one.
Good to know. I look forward to the day where a bridge gets cut on me unexpectedly.
Are you just gonna attack every bridge you see?
No, I don't want a bridge to get cut, but I'm sure I'm gonna be the fucking brunt end of the bridge getting cut. Ow.
Just hammering away at him.
Oh, right. I did this two-handed last time.
Oh, there's an item. An item over there.
Yeah, I just noticed that. I was like, whoa. Oh, humanity. Thanks.
Sweet.
I was like, wait, why am I not killing this drake very fast? They're like, oh, yeah, I two-handed all these drakes last time.
It's a valid strategy.
Well, it's not like I'm going to fucking block anything. Wow, well, not then, all of a sudden.
Do you think you're gonna block during the boss fight?
Yeah.
Don't die now.
No, what the fuck? I just.
Got stomped.
That was only 8,000 souls, but still, what the fuck?
You face tanked them.
But they all of a sudden didn't fight like they normally do. You know? It just like, I just fought them.
I mean,
them
they
like
have a variety of attacks they can do. I think what's happening a bit here is that you're trying to stats your way through fights instead of, like, fighting smart at all.
Actually,
like,
you
seem to make no attempts to avoid damage, and you just try to hope that you'll power through every enemy and then just heal.
It's a lot nicer.
Yeah, but it's
makes
not,
the game
you're not going to get any better at the games, and then you can't really act surprised when you die from that approach.
I'm surprised because, like, it was, for one, it was, the thunder was pushing me back. Like, somehow their movement was pushing me away from them. As in, like, oh, I'm gonna shoot thunder at you. Now you get pushed out of the range of me. And I was like, well, that didn't happen before. Why?
Well, you did significantly reduce your poise.
Is it really that big of a stat? Or, like, even just basic, just a basic shrug?
I mean, it literally is the stat that determines whether or not you can power through an enemy attack or if you get stunned by it. That's the entire premise of that stat.
What a fucking pain in the ass.
So you're wearing lighter armor now, and so you have to deal with what lighter armor people normally do.
Which is apparently not brunt through attacks.
Like, even when you're wearing heavy armor, it's not necessarily smart to just, like, stand in front of stuff and just take every hit you can, which is how you've dealt with every drake so far.
I can't dodge the thunder.
Yeah, you can.
Yeah, I can run around him, but I can't run around the first drake. I can't avoid the first drake's attacks at all. I can run backwards, but that doesn't help me because then he'll just eventually fly at me and then I can run away from him.
It's a frontal cone, so all you have to do is dodge the side and then you're out of the attack.
But it's a cone that he goes from left to right with. and there's not a left or right I can go to because it's on a ledge. The only way I can go is back.
So or right.
I can't.
Because right is the wall.
Well, right is the wall, but it's like he starts at the wall. He's like shooting through the wall, literally. So, like, yeah, look, I'll show you. His fucking. I can't do anything with this Drake but go backwards.
Well, going backwards doesn't work for rolling like, because he literally attacks backwards.
Like, there's nothing. In that time, he didn't physically attack me. There's nothing, like, you can do about that one Drake. You just have to take his damage. This one you can kind of avoid, I guess, but you need to, like, dodge to the left and then to the right first.
I'm pretty sure you could just dodge to the right when that guy's doing the first cone, the first one. I don't think there's really anything stopping you. Basically that, but to the right, actually.
That was weird. But I'll just accept it as a part of low armor.
I think what happened there is you collided with like their wing hitbox and got pushed around.
Yeah.
Like a boss fight's tail. Oop.
Ooh. Well, was not what I expected. All right. So now let's make our way. Had a good setup going, man. Good setup.
That's arguably what a good boss fight does, is kind of have you reassess your approaches to previous fights.
Which were perfect? Like, hey, your approach is really good. You managed to take out two of the important bosses so far.
If you could fight every boss the same way through an entire game, then they wouldn't be very good bosses.
I mean, says you.
That's the goal of making bosses in every game.
I mean, it doesn't impact me as a player. I'm pretty content with it.
So you want every Mega Man boss to feel like the same fight over and over again? And not challenge you in different ways and have you question what your approach to things and stuff?
I particularly am not... Oh, he's gone forever. I'm particularly not, like, invested in any kind of particular boss fight. I could take it or leave it. I honestly would probably... Are you guys following me through here? No.
I really question sometimes what you want out of video games ever.
I want them to be fun for me.
What does that mean?
Yeah, what
do
does that mean?
Do you never want to be challenged at all? Is that
no,
the
I do. I want challenges, but
is
when
every
I...
game supposed to be Dynasty Warriors?
No, I just want...
button mash?
I just want challenges when I want challenges. What, when I don't want challenges, I don't want challenges.
What does that mean?
It just means that I'm not a fucking machine, that I just don't sit there and go beep boop, all right, following orders, this is game... Game does exactly as game does.
I've been playing games with you for 6 years and I have no idea what you expect from them.
Just not Dark Souls. The Abyss. So... Oh, there you are. Oh. Oop. Oh, are you floating? Like, literally? Can I get close to you?
He's big.
How big are you? On a scale of big to big. I didn't like that. That looked kind of bad.
Yeah, you shouldn't get hit by that.
Well, I dodged it. Oh, I didn't dodge it. Or did I get hit by his sword? I really
can't. Well, that was two of them.
Can I block?
Good luck. So you can block, but their attacks do partial elemental damage.
Wait, what are you doing? Oh. That was scary. I guess this is kind of worthless. I'll take that. It certainly doesn't do much damage.
What are those hits? Are you blocking those hits,
nope.
Or are those non-blocked
hits? They're non-blocked hits.
Wow. His sword really doesn't do that much to you, so those swipes. There's now another one.
Oh yeah, I think it's just a constant stream of them for a while. Yeah, I'm under the impression that it's just a constant stream.
I'm confused, are you blocking or not?
I'm not.
So why aren't you two-handing then?
I am, or I was. stop.
It's really funny watching that happen. The loop of just taking every hit to the face and then just trying to heal through it. That's an explosion again.
Yep. That's fine. That does the most damage, honestly.
Oh, they do have a little tiny health bar.
Oh, that did a lot more damage than I expected it to.
I do not remember that swipe being so embarrassing. Like, he's like slowly flaking away damage.
Is he supposed to be like a boss? You call yourself the four kings of what? Where are you? Where'd you go?
I think you actually got ahead of the DPS curve just now when you started two-handing.
Can I? Oh, there you are.
Yeah, you actually outpaced the rate they spawn at. So you were lagging behind because you were one-handing. So you weren't dealing the damage you were hoping
shit,
to deal.
That was scary. Don't do that.
Yeah, energy attacks are dangerous. Wow, first attempt. Okay. That. I'm really having a strong revelation right now about how much that fight is a gear check. Holy shit. Holy shit.
Why did I take my armor off? I could have just fat rolled the entire time.
Yeah, you literally didn't roll the entire fight. I don't think. After, like, maybe the first part.
I'm learning a very important lesson here, Keith. The important lesson is that Dark Souls is literally just shit. You just have to get the right stats first. Once you just get enough stats, you kind of just... your way to victory.
We'll see how you handle Dark Souls 2 with that idea.
Well, I'm just saying Dark Souls is that way. Oh, there's a fucking bonfire here. Well, handy.
I had so much trouble with that boss fight, but I fought him in like episode 13 of my playthrough.
Oh, wow, that's pretty quick.
Because he's the only one of the four great souls you can do early because there's no gate in the way.
Well, how do you get the ring? I don't remember how I got this
Sif.
Ring. Oh, wait, you went to Sif already?
Yeah, because Sif's just sitting there. You can go right after Sif, basically. If you can get past the Hydra and stuff, you just go after Sif. So you go kill Sif, get the ring, then you just go take on Artorias at that point.
True.
I mean, not Artorias, Four Kings. So, like, I did it really early, and it felt impossible.
Yeah, I'd imagine.
It felt completely impossible. But it was both me with earlier game, shittier gear, but also me being way worse at the game than I am now. So, like, man... It is bizarre to watch you just mindlessly R1 your way through Four Kings, completely shattering my idea of that being a hard boss.
Let's see. Well, these are still better, so I guess I'll keep the fucking kill.
It's interesting looking at this, because I'm looking at this, like, out of all the bosses, the one interesting challenge I'll have to deal with probably in the main game is ONS.
Yeah.
Everything else is like, yeah, that's fine. Like, I don't see myself having trouble with, like, any other fights in this game. The fights in the DLC are relatively hard, though.
There we go. Selected the wrong one.
Alright, so what's your next goal? Do you want to do the DLC, or do you want to do the fourth big soul?
Let's do the fourth big soul. Let's get it all...
That, here you are. This is where you go.
Yep, so let's just get that out of the way.
Are you going to spend your souls?
Ah.
You have, like, almost two levels worth.